Why? Why won't you let me take you to the hospital?
I'm not an animal. I treat you like an animal in a hospital.
No, not at Cedars. I know the place is wonderful. I work there. I know it's wonderful. It's a wonderful place.
Go.
All right. All right, then what if I... What if I call a doctor? I get a doctor and have him come here.
No, I don't trust him. I don't trust anybody but you. You.
Reva, he's gonna die if he doesn't get proper care.
My sister's right. You know she is. I want you to live! Please, let me help you live, please! Regret this. I'll see to it that they take good care of you. Get under his arm.
I'd rather die alone in the woods.
Okay, you win. I won't force you to go anywhere, but please just come back inside, please. I'll do for you whatever I can.
Lynn Matthews, I want you to listen to me. Simon is nothing but trouble.
He is not, Mom.
He is, too.
Mom, he is a good friend. He's one of my best.
Will you help me try to get this through to her, please? She will not understand that some men will do anything they can to deceive a young girl, that they aren't always what they seem. Jessie, getting you taken to jail with him was just the beginning. Tell her, Ross.
Yeah, it's true. Jesse, you know, I'm not one of Simon's biggest fans, but as far as the arrest is concerned, the damage was minimal. It's not going to go on Jesse's record.
It never would have happened if she hadn't been seeing Simon.
That is not true. Would you just listen to me for once? This whole mess wouldn't have happened if I wouldn't have let it. I'm the one who left the cash register open in the first place. He only got involved because he was trying to help me out, Mother. He wanted to protect me. He could have walked away from this whole mess and saved himself a lot of hassle, but he didn't, did he? No, he stayed here and he put himself on the line for me. And I think it's really unfair of you to be misjudging him like this. If anything at all, you should be thanking him for what he did.
You're not getting serious about this young man, are you, Jessie? Jessie?
Maybe it's time you went back to work.
No.
Calla, let it go, let it go. We'll talk about it later when you both had more time to think.
I think that's a good idea. Excuse me.
Listen, Rick. Mr. Shane is Roxie's father. He's a little overprotective, you know?
Kurt, I hate to admit this, but some of what he said is right.
Oh?
I have been neglecting Roxie. And the trouble is, I cannot see any way to stop neglecting her, not for the time being.
That accelerated program, huh?
Yeah. Oh, man, sometimes a career can be so demanding. You know, your personal life, it has to take a back seat. Sometimes it even winds up in the trunk.
Yeah. Yeah, I know that feeling.
Well, that's right. You're going through the same thing with Mindy being Sam's girl, right?
Yep.
Well, how are you going to handle it?
I don't know. It's all pretty new to me.
Yeah, well, it's getting real old for Roxie and I mean, ever since I've been in the accelerated program, all I have time for is to sleep, study, or I'm at the hospital. I mean, it's no wonder Roxie feels lonely or jealous. We haven't made love in over a month. I've just had a chance just to hold it. Charlie, you know what? It's been a quiet evening together alone having dinner. On the one night she needed me the most.
Samson girl.
Right. I mean, I can't even imagine how hurt she must have been. You know, and I wasn't even there to help her out after she lost.
Rick, what did happen that night?
I was working rounds at the hospital. Good old Dr. Sadist. Ramsey had me working there all hours of the evening. Kurt, sometimes I feel like I have no control of my life anymore.
Listen, Rick, believe it or not, there is a light at the end of this tunnel. I mean, that program is not going to go on forever. You just got to hang in there as long as you can.
I'm trying, buddy. I'm trying.
What's that? Oh, my God, no! The train's crashed! The train's crashed! It's starting to roll over. Oh, my God, no, I gotta get out of here. The cages are busted.
Good.
All the animals.
How does the fever
the animals
is?
Are
he
running.
Needs all the warmth he can get. That
lions,
stupid radiator
lions,
shut down again.
Tigers. Oh, God, they're running. Oh, God, I gotta catch them. I gotta catch them. I gotta catch them. I gotta catch them before they... Catch them!
Oh. Really, you think that wreck he was talking about is the train crash that happened a few months ago? Train? Yeah, don't you remember? Oh, that was the night you were in the river. Yeah, it was a big deal. If two people died, a bunch of animals escaped.
I did read something about that. It was a circus train, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
They caught the last escaped animal. It was a snow leopard.
Yeah, but I don't remember him saying anything about any people being missing.
No, well, we'll just have to ask him when he gets better.
Question is, how are we going to make him better?
We?
Well, I'm not going to let you go through this alone.
Thanks, sis. Oh, honey, there's got to be something more we can do for him.
Between everything we learned from Mom and Miss Martha, there's got to be some surefire home remedy we could whip up for him.
Oh, honey... Hot toddy! Yes, sweats out the fever and cleans out the lungs.
Brandy, lemon juice, honey, and hot water.
I've got all that stuff. Oh, except the brandy.
No problem. Let's go to company and get some.
Oh, good. What is it?
I just left there. Rick's there. We had an argument before I came over here.
Well, that's okay. I'll go myself.
No, better me. Less questions will be asked. You stay here. I'll be right back.
Okay. You're wrong. I'm not as cold and unfeeling as you seem to think.
Oh, Alex, I
loved my family. I loved my son.
I know you did, but that love's been turned into hate and distrust.
How dare you say that about me?
Because no matter how much you loved before, you've cut yourself off from everyone since Lou Jack died.
What do you expect? He was everything to me. He was...
You know, it's strange that ever since my mother died, well, the pain was so incredible that I thought no other grief could ever come close. But then I went to the funeral of a man that I hadn't even met. And the outpouring of love in that chapel and the sense of loss was so intense that I couldn't help but feel and share with them. And then I felt a bond between that man and me, even in death. You don't know how many times since then that I wish I had a chance to really know Lou Jack.
Oh, you will stoop to any tactic, won't you? You are even willing to use my son's death to try to manipulate me.
I'm sorry you feel that way. You're wrong. I'm speaking from the heart.
Heart?
What heart?
You flatter yourself.
No matter what you say, Alex, I know how connected Lujak was to me.
No.
Yes. He was family. He and I shared the same blood.
You're lying. It is all lies.
Yeah, that's Mindy Corday, room 1414. No answer? Yeah, as a matter of fact, I would like to leave a message. The message is, I love you, and I miss you. Kurt. Thanks. Bye.
Amber, I've been thinking about this. Maybe it'd be better if I just... if I was alone, my son rocks up about this jealousy business. You know, I don't want to put her on the spot.
Right. I'll head over to Cedars.
Okay, we'll see you later.
Rick.
Yeah.
There's something else I think you ought to discuss with her while you're at it.
The pills.
Well, I know it'll come to her as a shock at first, but I think in the long run...
Amber,
it's always better to be open with the people.
Amber, I don't want her to ever know about this, ever.
But
it's over now.
Rick, wouldn't it be reassuring to know you have somebody to turn to? I mean, somebody who knows what you're going through?
I've got you.
Right. Oh, well, I better be going.
Okay.
I don't understand why you were so intent on pushing Jessie back to work.
Because it's better than pushing Jessie back into Simon's arms.
I wasn't doing that. That's exactly what I was trying to prevent.
Calla, when you were a teenager, how did you react to your parents' advice?
I did everything they asked.
Mm, always?
Well,
as I recall, they objected to both me and Gordon.
Well, I say so.
Mm-hmm. So who did you immediately start seeing more and more of?
You and Gordon.
I rest my case.
All right. Point well taken. But even so, I can't help being concerned about Simon.
Hey. Well, so am I. Simon may very well be an imposter, but I also think you should have a little more faith in the daughter that you raised.
Thank you. You've been a great help to us. Me. Again.
I wouldn't mind making a habit of it. I wouldn't mind at all.
I need 2 beers and a white wine.
Oh, yeah. Come down.
And, tell me, wasn't there something you wanted to talk to me about before?
Yeah, you're right.
Well, with these two prescriptions and that pill I found in Four West. Thank you very much for your help. Mr. Briggs.
Well, I'm real glad. And I'm sure you'll know how to show your appreciation.
I think now's the time or the place.
Mm-hmm. Couldn't be better. I'm a great admirer of the here and now. May I demonstrate?
If you insist.